The Philippine economy is expected to return to its pre-pandemic levels between late 2022 and early 2023. That's according to Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Carl Chua, who previously said this would be achieved within next year. He cites the recent spikes in COVID-19 cases and the resulting lockdowns for the updated outlook. But he adds recovery prospects for 2021 remain promising.
The enablers of our recovery hinge on acceleration of the vaccination program, the continued safe reopening of the economy while adhering to the health protocols, and the full implementation of our recovery package, which includes the present 2021 budget, the CREATE law, and the FIS law.
The country's economic managers earlier slashed their growth targets for this year to 4 to 5%. From 6 to 7%. They still expect the economy to grow up to 9% in 2022.
Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte changes his tune over gambling in Boracay. He says he will now allow a casino to be built in the popular tourist destination because government needs more funds.
Magsabi ka ba, to si Duterte, bakit sabi mo ayaw mo ng sugal? Tapos ngayon, basi nyo sa Boracay, yung gambling house doon, ini-encourage yung buksan para sa tourist. Patawarin na po ninyo ako for the contradiction. Ngayon po, wala tayong pera. Kung saan man tayo makakuha ng pera, kukunin ko. Kung dyan sa gambling, so be it. Kung wala akong isang salita dyan, tama yan, wala akong isang salita dyan. Pero kailangan ko ng pera para patakbuhin ang gobyerno kasi marami akong gagastusan.
In 2018, Duterte ordered Boracay should be casino-free when the island reopened after its rehabilitation. Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez expects government's borrowings to drop to 2.25 trillion pesos in 2022 from 3 trillion pesos this year. Dominguez says government's debt remains manageable thanks to prudent fiscal management. But he notes debt to GDP ratio is projected to slightly increase to 60% in 2022 from the programmed 59% in 2021. The country's debt has risen steadily during President Rodrigo Duterte's term, hitting over 11 trillion pesos at the end of June. That's nearly double from the 5.9 trillion peso debt at the start of Duterte's term in 2016. But government defends the loans, saying more money is needed to fund the Duterte administration's infrastructure program as well as its COVID-19 response. Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte tells the public not to believe graft investigations as he defended his cabinet from corruption allegations. He says nothing comes out from these probes. Both houses of Congress are currently looking into the health department's supposed mismanagement of its multi-billion peso pandemic response budget after being flagged by state auditors.
Pakinggan mo yung mga ibang senador dyan, meron talagang masabi. After an investigation, 1 or 2 or 3 days you hearing, wala na. Walang rekomendasyon, walang dinemanda, walang napriso. Puro postura lang, question.
Duterte also vowed to audit the whole government if he wins as vice president in the 2022 elections. Duterte, who has been criticizing the commission on audit since it released its findings on the health department, said the COA itself should be audited.
I will do that if I become Vice President. Ako na lang rin ang mag-audit sa lahat ng gobyerno. Lahat. Pati yung akin. Mag-umpisa ako sa akin.
The country's finance chief believes all Filipinos can be vaccinated against COVID-19 by early next year. Secretary Carlos Dominguez says government has secured nearly 200 million doses, which he says is enough to inoculate the entire population. The Philippines has so far received about 50 million of these jabs. Some 100 million more shots are expected to arrive from October to December.
Actually, we are expecting roughly 50 million doses a month from September to December. If that happens, oh, siguro by January, we should have been able to inoculate everyone. Oh. Wala ho tayong problema sa pera. May financing na lahat yan. At we don't have to worry about any about money here. We have already all the money ready to be paid for these doses.
13.3 million Filipinos have been fully vaccinated against the coronavirus, while 18 million have received their first dose.
The Philippine Drug Regulator anticipates commercial availability of COVID vaccines in the country by early next year. Food and Drug Administration Chief Eric Domingo expects Pfizer to seek a product registration certificate for its COVID vaccine in the Philippines. U.S. regulators recently granted full approval for Pfizer's vaccine. Domingo believes other manufacturers may follow suit in the last quarter of the year. He agrees with Presidential Advisor Joey Concepcion that prices of COVID jabs may increase once they're given full approval.
Very likely yan. Dahil ngayon, syempre, pinapangako ng mga companies na nagbebenta sila nito sa mga gobyerno ng walang tubo, di ba? Bilang tulong sa worldwide drive natin against COVID-19. Pero syempre, kapag ito ay naging marketing authorization na, magkakaroon na ng pagbabago.